just make sure that the live stream is working, that we're live, and we do a little intro. Cool. So we're live. It is, what's the date today? May 17th at 1:30 p.m. Pacific time, West Coast Canada. And welcome everyone who's coming to the stream live. And for those of you watching the stream when it's been uploaded to BitChute or YouTube, just to let you know what we're about to do. Basically what I'm doing is I'm incorporating the live streaming with the recording videos and editing videos and stuff like this. So what we're doing right now is sort of a behind the scenes video live stream, just to show you how I end up creating content in video format, recorded, where I take it into editing. And what we're about to do is we're about to continue with our conversation regarding on how to study. And just so you know, anything that I reference in the live stream will be links will be provided in the description of this video once it's loaded on BitChute or YouTube or whatever platform you do load this on. Okay, so if there's anything that you're looking for that I do reference, please look in the description of this video and I will provide links to any videos or any playlists. But what we're about to do basically is do a live stream of me recording how to study video. And if you've been following that series, if you want to know what we're talking about, there's a sort of a playlist I've put together in YouTube, and there's I believe there's like 7 videos, but there's basically 6 or 8 videos in that playlist. But there's basically 6 tips that I've shared so far regarding on how to study, and we're just basically going to continue our conversation from there. The first one that you see here was basically putting out a video a few years ago, back in 2000 and something, talking about, you know, we sort of have to ask ourselves why it is that we're studying something. We sort of, that's sort of a rant on the first one, talking about how you can look at something the way, you know, if you're going to study something or do something, if you're going to look at it through the lens of hate or love, and it's much easier to absorb information if you're coming at it from at least a dislike, a not hate perspective, right? And then what we did after that, we sort of did another video, sort of part two of that, talking about that if you're going to study, it's much more efficient to basically sit down and do long sessions than it is to sit down and do multiple short sessions, right? Short sessions are good for reviews, but if you're really trying to get something done, it's really important to sit down and do a long session. Okay, the third video we put out in that series was this one, which is basically talking about us finding sort of our happy space, where we are comfortable studying whatever it is that we're studying, right? Sometimes it's on a desk, sitting on a chair, sometimes it's at a park, sometimes it's at a beach, sometimes it's just walking if you need to hash out different things, right? So there's multiple ways that you can ease the studying, the amount of work and energy you have to put into studying. And once you end up being in a comfortable area where you are reviewing or studying, learning something new, then you tend to like what it is that you're doing, which connects up to the first video where we talked about, right? The fourth video in this set, in this playlist that we put together, was basically a video talking about that one of the most important things that you can do for yourself if you're trying to get a whole bunch of stuff done, especially for people in university, or if you're working on your own project, is to create a schedule and to create a to-do list. So in this fourth video, we sort of went through how to create a schedule. We talked about flow charts and stuff like this, and we talked about how you can create a to-do list and maybe knock things off, you know, 2 or 3 different things off in one go, right? Layering your work, which is a very efficient way to get things done, right? And the fifth video in this series, what we did was basically talk about how to read a textbook, and we took 3 different types of textbook and we sort of talked about each one of those. And I sort of put out 2 different videos for that from the same shoot. One of them was the full-on ASMR version, which was hour plus minutes long, and the other one was sort of a condensed version where it's like 20 points of how to read a textbook. And the sixth video we put out in this set was us taking a look at different types of math problems that we might encounter in high school specifically, and realizing that to solve a certain type of problem, there's a certain pattern to it, right? And we sort of talked about the best way you can learn math, algebra, is basically recognize what type of problem you have and remember the pattern, the visual on it, right? So what we're gonna do right now is create a seventh tip, seventh video, or I guess it's the ninth video because we're not talking about the introduction and re-editing another video, the video that we did regarding how to read a textbook, right? But basically, this is the seventh tip in the series of how to study. And in this one, basically, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how to take notes, okay? And the way, just so you know, the way I end up doing these shoots, I usually set myself up, and sometimes I'm lucky enough to be able to capture what I want to capture in one go. Sometimes I have to do it again. This is my first go at creating this video, and I'm sort of getting back into editing video and stuff like this. So this is sort of an experiment, putting these two different techniques together, right? The live streaming and recording, right? Which is sort of the same thing, but you have to take care of the lighting and whatnot, right? It's a little bit different, a little bit fine tuning required. So hopefully we'll end up using this shoot, but just in case everything doesn't flow as well as I, you know, it's flowing in my head, as well as the notes that I've taken and things I've laid out, I'll probably end up reshooting this if it doesn't work out well enough, okay? And just to let you know, this is sort of our initial little intro video, and there will be a description, there will be a link to when we actually start the shoot in the description of this video. I should have mentioned this at the beginning, right? But basically, these are the two angles that we're going to use to shoot this video, okay? So let me take this off. And this is the angle that we're using. I have, let me give you the layout of the land, because one of the reasons I'm making these videos as well is because people have been asking me how I end up creating content. And, you know, I've had a couple of people that are working with other students ask me how I'm doing this. And throughout the years, I've had people ask me, you know, what type of mic I'm using, what type of gear and stuff I'm using, what type of lighting I'm using. So I thought this would be an amazing opportunity to share that information as well, just in case anyone wants to create content just to make life easier for them, right? So this is what we have right now. I have my mic set up here that we're doing the live stream from. I'm going to be using a lapel mic that I'm going to be recording sound on, an external recording device, very cheap. Like, this mic cost me like $15 US. This thing I bought a few years ago, cost me like $100. It's more, it was more the high end one, and it's already glitchy, so I have to tape it down when I record it. But it's, you know, the gear doesn't cost that much, okay? I do have an HD camera that cost me a few $100 to get, okay? And that's set up here, and I got this thing set up on a tripod. I got things tied down, and I have one camera set up here that is shooting the angle that we're seeing in this corner right here, right? If I change this view, so this guy right here, okay, that's the camera coming from here, and this is the camera that I've jerry-rigged with painting tape on another tripod that I have. This is another tripod that I have. I just took the top off of it, hooked it onto this tripod, and I have that hanging, and that's the view that we're seeing here, okay, which is going to be sort of mimicking the view that we're getting from the HD camera, okay? Apologies about the long intro to this video. Nice setup, thanks, brother. And people, and I've set up the chat, obviously the chat's popping up. So I've basically, you know, try to fine tune things that I'm able to do everything in one shot, right? So what we'll do, we'll spend a little bit of time just saying hello and salutations and stuff like this, and we'll do the, probably after the shoot, we'll come back and do a little chit chat after the shoot, if you guys like. Mod held a message for Sanctuary. Okay, that guy's gonna be done. The production quality has been rapidly evolving each stream. Loving it. Thanks, man. Thank you. I'm trying my best anyway. Oh man, how did we do? Usually I like having at least one mod here. Hello, Spamalot, how are you doing? Okay, man. Until we get some mods, I'm gonna, because auto mod is it's nice, it's grabbing some some okay, cool. I just ended up banning someone because they're, you know, the troll factory people. Hello from Norway. Hello from Canada. Salutations. Salutations. So we'll see what happens. I might if we don't end up if we end up getting trolls and stuff like this posting comments, and if we don't get any mods coming in. Greetings from Turkey. Hello Turkey, how are you doing? I know some Turkish words. What I might do is get rid of the chat in the view that we have here. So you won't see the chat appearing on this side. Well, we'll see how that goes. I might just leave it because the trolls end up coming and going. It's sort of like a flow, like a wind, like a gust of wind comes in. All right. So how are we doing for time? We're about 11 minutes in. And oh yeah, let me. We did go through all the intro, the playlist and stuff. Yeah, ICOs. And by the way, on Saturday, what we're gonna be doing Saturday evening, we're gonna be doing. Ah, thanks a lot for the sub, Spamalot. Appreciate it. And on Saturday, what we're gonna be doing, we're gonna be talking cryptocurrencies. Hi, Rays. How are you doing, Ray? What we're going to be doing is talking about cryptocurrencies. And again, this is going to be a setup that we're going to do in another room. And I'm sort of experimenting with a little bit of lighting. And the setup I'm going to try to do for that video is going to be sort of along the same setup that we did for the finance videos. But it's going to be during sunset and dusk. So there's a very limited time frame that we have. But the lighting is nice. It sort of gets darker and darker. So I'm going to set up some artificial lights as well, and hopefully capture those during the stream. So we'll see how that goes, right? And again, all of this, some of these might be just test run shoot. We might not end up using this. You've clearly worked very hard over the last 10 years on YouTube. You deserve. Oh, thank you very much, man. I have. It's been fun doing it. Wow, what a learning process it has been. Absolutely fantastic. Really, it's been an amazing learning curve. I can't even think, imagine of doing something else, right? Just the payback, the reward on a feel-good basis has been phenomenal, priceless, priceless. Okay. So let's check it out. We don't have any mods here yet. So I think we'll keep the chat on. I don't think we got auto mod going and whatnot, so we're not getting too many bad text coming up. But I'll check the computer every now and then. Okay. Jules, Jules, the cheers. Thanks for the cheers, brother. Fun. Let's check this out. That stuff is popping up. That stuff is popping up. So what do you guys say? Should we do this? I gotta set up my recorder. And what I do with this is, I don't like setting it up beforehand because I do use tape, so I don't want too much pressure to be on it. So I basically throw the thing in, right? And I take a little bit of masking tape and just lock it up. Let me show you. I pull a little bit from here, right? Just to make sure there's enough pressure on the connection in the top, right? Because it's gone a little loose, and if I don't do this, I get ticking sounds in the recording of the lapel mic going into here, and I have to deal with that a little bit before I figured out what the problem was. I was almost on my way of buying some more equipment. Art Jews, how are you doing? Chicho, for sharing time with grandma, love the again. Thanks, man. It was fantastic. She kicked my ass. She kicked my ass. Archers, how do you feel about, I don't, no obligation, you don't have to say yes. How do you feel about becoming a mod on Twitch? Again, no obligation, since there's no mods here right now, and no obligation of staying, really, for any length of time. I know it's a little bit of responsibility. I don't really wanna make anyone feel obliged to doing this type of stuff. So, if you're okay with it, and I just usually turn the sucker on, and it gives me a little thing, and the little lapel mic has a little thing here that I gotta turn on, right? Let me turn this guy on too. He hasn't replied yet, so might leave it as that. I would love to. Just tell me what I have to do. No problem. You know what? I'll just do, and did it work? Oops. Oh, I misspelled your name. Okay, you're a mod now. So you're gonna have a little sword appear by your name. And basically, I don't know. If I see there's timeout function on chat and there's a ban function, I just banned someone because they were just blatant. Like it was like a 2-year-old trolling, right? It wasn't even 2-year-old. It was like whatever it was, right? Hey Chicho, I made it. I hope it's not over. No, we're just starting, Anna. We're just starting. We got a new mod. Thank you, brother. Appreciate it. It's not a, you know, there's other mods. They're very helpful. There's no one here right now. The timing is wacko, I guess. But it's an easy task and no obligation. You can leave, come, decide to deal with people or not deal with people. Okay. Nice. Okay, guys. So I got the setup. This is on. I got my camera on. I'm gonna change the view. We'll keep the chat going. Thank you, Archers. A truce. Okay, so let me do our little thing. And I'm not gonna do any pop-up videos or anything when we're doing a live stream. I'm gonna try to do all that in the editing of the video. And again, this is the first try at this. That's why I staggered the streams. The next one is going to be Saturday instead of tomorrow. Because that way, if I don't like the shoot, the way it's turning out, I'm going to redo it. Okay. Without live streaming. That way I have less to deal with. Right. Hello, question 67. Bro. Captain Grabber 69. Welcome, welcome. Are we just starting? We are just starting. I'm about to change the angles. Okay. And you'll find out what this video is about, I guess, when we start shooting it, okay? Here's the angles that we're gonna use. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna lift the chair up. That way, it's not too noisy. Let me adjust myself. Let's do this. Lock myself in. And I'll check the chat, as often as I can. Okay. Let's set this up. Where are you from, my brother? Ancestry Armenian? I guess I'll talk here. Ancestry Armenian, born in Iran. Most of my life in Canada, West Coast. Okay, guys, let's try this out. So, took us 20 minutes to get this, so let me turn on the sound, make sure the sound's going. Let's turn on this guy too. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. So we'll lock this guy up. Turn on the camera. Test, test, 1, 2, 3. And what I do, I usually lock up the cord of the recorder as well. Okay, that's good. Apologies about the computer sound, by the way. At some point, we'll try to get rid of the humming of this computer sound. Hopefully, the lapel mic is not picking up too much. I can filter that out in the recordings. Okay. Do it lightly so it's not too loud. Hi everyone, this is Chicho. Welcome to my channel. What I thought we'd do in this video is continue our discussion regarding how to study. And this is basically something, sort of a playlist, a project we started a while ago, where just trying to center things. Let's do another click. Hi everyone, this is Chicho. Welcome to my channel. What I thought we'd do in this video is continue our discussion regarding how to study. Basically, if you recall, we've put together a playlist talking about a few different things, a few different tips. Sharing with you guys a few different tips that I have regarding studying, regarding learning something new. And if you recall, what we've done is basically in the first video, what we talked about is we sort of have to ask ourselves why it is that we're trying to study something, right? And we sort of, I did a sort of a little discussion on, you know, the perspective you can use on studying, that you can either decide to hate what you're doing or slowly try to realize that it is something that you need to do and sort of move towards loving what it is that you're doing. And that helps you retain the information a lot better, right? And then after that, what we did, we put our second video talking about that it's usually a better idea to sit down and do long sessions, long study sessions instead of a lot of short ones. A lot of short ones are good for reviewing content, refreshing yourself. But if you're learning something new, it's a better idea to do longer sessions, right? And from there, we sort of went on into tip number three, is basically talking about that. It might be a good idea just to, you know, find your happy space, right? Maybe sitting behind the table, in a, you know, in a chair upright, studying what it is that you're studying, or going out to the park, going out to the beach, going for a walk if you want to recite something, memorize something. So basically, be comfortable where you are, because if you're comfortable, happy about where you are doing the work, whatever it is that you're doing, the odds are you probably retain that information and learn it much faster, right? And what we did in the fourth video was basically in tip number four, we talked about one of the best things you can do is set yourself up with a schedule and create a to-do list and, start knocking things off, right? And if possible, basically create a to-do list that has your needs and your wants and hopefully overlap those things and try to do a few things in one go, right? Basically layering your work. And what's going to happen? Slowly you end up finding out that you end up getting a lot done, right? And then for tip number five, basically what we did was take a look at on how we can read a textbook, right? And that's one thing that I found out with a lot of my students is, they're given textbooks in school, but a lot of them don't really appreciate, don't really know how to use the textbook, right? How to read a textbook, right? And then after that, what we did was basically talk about when you're doing algebra specifically, if you get some kind of problem in algebra, there's a certain method to solving certain types of problems, right? So we talked about that. It's a pretty good idea to be able to recognize the type of problem you're getting and familiarize yourself with the pattern required to solve that problem, right? Get a visual of how to go about solving that problem. And I thought what we'd do in this video is continue on with that discussion, specifically overlaying this, overlapping this with the fifth video we put out regarding on how to read a textbook. Because when you're doing what you're doing when you're reading a textbook is you're usually trying to take notes, and we talked about that a little bit in that video, where you can take notes either on the side or in the textbook itself, highlighting things, right? But one of the things you can do is take notes in a notebook, right? So I thought what we'd do is take a look at some of the notebooks I've used over the years, and I brought out basically six notebooks here, okay, just to show you guys. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna flip through these two, time allowing, right? But I have different types of notebooks that I use in different places. Sometimes I want to be mobile, so I don't carry the bigger, larger textbooks. Sometimes I carry smaller textbooks with me. Sometimes I carry pieces of paper, take a piece of paper and throw it in your pocket with a pen if you want to be mobile, right? So there's a lot of different ways that you can take notes. Taking notes is very personal, and if you go online, you'll find out that there's a whole bunch of different different things that people recommend on what the best practice is to take notes, okay? Some people, they sit there. I mean, this is one piece of paper that I have, and that's sort of mobile for me to travel with, right? So, and I usually like using 11 by 17 paper, right? Large sheets of paper, because I can fold them like this. And if you're walking, if you don't have a table, if you, can't lean on something to write something, these work out fine because they're thick enough that you can write on, put pressure on, right? So you can sit there and go, Chicho, you can write on it, right? And one thing you'll do is, if you notice, if you do a little bit of searching on what the best practice is on how to take it, how to take notes, you'll find out that different people recommend different things, right? Some people say, take notes in bullet form, basically like this. I'm not sure if this is coming out nicely or not. Let's see if we have a dark, thicker pen here. No, we do right here. Check this out. Nice. So some people say basically, to take point form like this and, make titles, make sections, divide these things out like this. And you'll see some of the stuff in the notes that I'm going to show you. Some people say basically, if you're doing comparison, create tables and write down notes if you're comparing things, and use sort of bullet format when you're doing this as well, right? So you can break down your page in this format. Some people say there's some kind of standards that I did a search for when I was looking to see, what else I could share with you guys. Some people say, create, this format, which I've never used myself, where you put basically a label here, where you put basically a topic here, whatever little specific notes that you have here. When you're reviewing books and whatnot, you can take your notes here, and then over here you can post questions, or you can talk about key issues, right? And then what you can do is summarize your information here, right? Sometimes you end up taking notes where you have something centralized and you're feeding information into that, or feeding out of that, right? If you're trying to understand a certain type of concept, and we've done a little bit of this in some of the math videos we've talked about, and you can put point form into these things. So it's taking notes is extremely personal. I had to think about this a lot when I was trying to share this information on how to take, what some of the best note taking practices are. And you can you can do a little search online and figure out for yourself what works best for you. Are you visual? Do you like flowcharts? Do you like the table format like this, which you can write a lot of notes here sort of in point form, and then associate that with questions you might have or key points you might have? Do you like summaries at the end of the page? Do you like everything to be organized in tables and point forms and stuff like this, right? So taking notes is extremely personal, and the best way to learn how to take notes is to start practicing, start trying things out if you haven't done so before. Okay, so I thought what we'd do, instead of talking about all these different versions of taking notes that you can use, I thought what we'd do is basically show you some of the notes that I've taken over the years, right? And right now I have, six booklets here that we have. I'm going to flip through two, and I'm going to show you a couple of things in these guys as well, and one thing in this, because this bottom one I just started, right? And just so you know, this is just six of the notebooks I have. There's three of them that are still open. Three of these are full up, right? But I need some information that I've put in here for some of the videos, some of the context we're creating, right? And I do have additional videos. I have a couple of dozen of the additional textbooks. So I have a couple of dozen of these notebooks that I have that I've used over the years to create content, to learn stuff or whatnot, right? And it's up to you how many textbooks you're comfortable as having floats. For me, I have this one